Now comes the fun part, guys. We've shown you pretty much the whole interface and what you can find around the interface as well as described it for you. However, now it's time to actually show you how to work with the program as we work with it. So I built this little script and an idea here, and it's sort of like, I don't know, a little commercial or liner for a radio station, which is what I usually do anyway. So it's going to be the dry script here is going to be, check it out. You're listening to 105.5 FM. That's 105.5 FM. And we're going to modify it, so you're going to get some stuttering on the C of check it out or CH of check it out, as well as the F of FM. We're going to add some real cool sound effects and backing tracks. We're going to affect the vocals so it sounds like the stuff that you can find on the audio section of SonicOrbStudios.com. So with that said, let's get started. We have our project. We've titled it. We've started the project and saved it, and it's in 44/100 hertz. You can see all that at the bottom of the information bar there. And so we've set our sound cards as the same sample rate. So the first thing we do is go to our input-output section on our track, and we're going to go and select the track that we need to do, that we need to record, or the input that we need to select from, and then we'll hit the arm track button, and you'll notice it starts lighting up right away. If you don't get this, right click and you can hit command or alt I, or you can hit this button right here at the top. It says meter input signal, and you should get that. If not, well, you may have to check your audio card settings because you're not on the right input at that point, or you may have to go into your preferences as well and check your audio hardware setup. So just be aware that there's different mapping and hardware, stuff like that, what we've gone through in the previous videos. So that said, let's get our script here on the right, and let's start tracking this. We're going to hit the record button at the bottom of the page, and I'm going to give it a few seconds, about 5 or 10 seconds of just silence, so it gets the ambience noise. The microphone will capture ambience noise, and you can sample that later in this program and help it clean up your audio track a little bit. It's great if you're in a slightly noisy room or if you have a really sensitive microphone such as a condenser. This time we're using a fairly decent microphone. I got the Heil Sound PR22UT, so it should be fairly quiet, and I like the crystal clearness of this microphone. So let's get this started here. Check it out. You're listening to 105.5 FM. FM. That's 105.5 FM. FM. So you'll notice there that I sort of did these pauses in between, and that's simply just because, you know, it's all digital. We could chop it up. Maybe I didn't like the first time I said FM or wanted to say it's slightly different to make it blend. And I did pause in between because we're going to be chopping these individual parts up and putting sound effects on each part, or maybe just a bit of each part. And so it makes it easier for me to go through here and insert edit points. So first thing, now that we're done recording, we can unarm our track. We're going to actually expand it down a little bit and zoom in. That way we can look a little bit better at this. And so before we do anything, we're going to normalize our track. We double-click on it, double-click again, and we'll go up to our effects up here at the top. We can go to amplitude, and we can normalize it to process. And we're going to normalize this to 0 dB. That would be 100%, by the way. And there we have that. Next thing we're going to do is actually capture the noise profile here. So we're going to select just this little area here, and we're going to go up to effects. It should be under restoration. Let's go find restoration. Here it is. Missed that. And we're going to go, and we have to capture our noise print. So Shift-P, and then we can go and do Control-Shift-P to do the noise reduction. So capture noise print. It'll be like, okay, current audio has been captured and loaded as a noise print and all that and blah, blah, blah. We don't have to show that again. It's just saying, hey, it's captured that. Now we have to select everything in our waveform here. And you'll notice if we go back to clip, we go under restoration, and we can do a noise reduction process. It'll bring up this nice graphical interface saying, okay, well, Here are our lows, our highs, our threshold, and there's no real highs that are here, but there's a lot of, I don't know, low rumble, especially on the left side. So if we go and click here, actually bring that right back to 70% where it was before, and maybe turn down the low end, you'll notice that the green sort of drops down there. You'll notice everywhere you adjust this, just do a drastic change here, and you can see that's what it's going to do. You also have different presets that you can sort of make after you do these for a while, but it should remember your settings. There's also advanced stuff that you can change, but really, we're going to stick with the basics for now, and we're just going to roll off the low end just a touch. We don't want to go too much because you will hear a difference in the low end. We're going to play this through, and we should be able to hear it once it hits here.
Check it out!
And it's really loud, of course, but it sounded good. It didn't sound all weird. So we're going to stick with that. Hit apply. It'll go through the track. Since it's a small clip, it should work just fine. And we've removed any noise that was playing here. You'll notice at the bottom here, no noise at all. And so that's going to be that. And we're going to jump back to our multi-track view. And I think this is going to wrap up the short clip. Now that we have this here, we're going to chop it up in the next video and start applying different effects, maybe find some backing audio and some sound effects. We've got some great royalty-free selections to go through, and we're going to work with this and sort of shape it into something amazing sounding. I'm Dave from SonicOrbStudios, and thanks for watching these great tutorials on Adobe Audition CS5.5. Check out my website, SonicOrbStudios.com, for some more amazing tips, tricks, and great tutorials on all these great pieces of software. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon.